Hey guys, it's Sarah with AmericanTrucks.com, and today we have a review and install of the Morimoto XB projector fog lights fitting your 17 to 19 Super Duty F-250 and F-350 models. These are perfect for the Super Duty owner who wants to upgrade their fog lights to a projector style LED and wants an option with black styling that's very easy to install. The LEDs in these fog lights are a nice upgrade over the halogen bulbs of your factory, and they are also DOT and SAE approved, meaning they're perfectly legal for on-road use. They are constructed from impact-resistant polycarbonate lenses with black powder-coated aluminum housings and a bright white LED. They feature a very simple install. There's no cutting of the factory plastic required. They just slide right into place of your factory, making them one of the most direct fit options. So as far as price goes, these come in at around $200, which is middle of the road price-wise when compared to other options. And for your money, you are getting a direct fit fog light with black styling and the bright white LED, so they really look great on or off. So as far as install goes, I'm giving this one a 1 out of 3 wrenches on the difficulty meter. It does feature the direct bolt up and plug and play install, as I said before, and can be done within 1 hour. So with that said, let's check out our install. For this install, you will need an impact gun or a ratchet, a 15mm socket, and you may want a swivel, a 7/32 socket, Phillips head screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver, and a pop clip removal tool. All right, so we have our truck here and we do have it in the air and supported with the wheel removed. Now you don't have to do this. Removing the wheel does give it a little bit more space to work with. We did this so you guys would have a better look at what we're about to do. So the first thing we're gonna do is grab a pop clip removal tool and remove part of the wheel well liner on the back of the bumper. All right, so the first thing you're gonna do is get your pop clip removal tool and get behind the pop clip and pull forward. There's a second pop clip down here, you're gonna do the same thing. Next up, you're gonna grab a 7/32 socket to remove these two bolts, one on each side. Next up, we're gonna remove this metal plate right here, the support for the bumper, so that we can get to the fog light a little bit easier behind it. Grab a 15mm socket, we're gonna remove these 4 bolts. Next up, there's 2 bolts towards the inside of the frame, remove those as well. You may want a swivel socket for the second one just to get a better angle on it if you're using a gun to go past the frame. Now that you can see your connector, go ahead and unplug it. Pull back on this tab and remove the connector. Next up, we're going to take a Phillips head screwdriver and loosen the screw that's right next to it. Be careful not to lose the spring. All right, so now that we have the spring and screw out of the side here, there are tabs on either side of the housing for the fog light itself. There's lots of different ways to pry on these, but basically they have to pry off enough that the fog light can fall forward. So what you're gonna do is with a flathead, just gently pry back on these tabs on the side. You can do this on the outside as well. Once you have both sides released, the fog light should pop right out the front. All right, so what we need to do here is we're gonna reuse this piece of plastic that holds in your screw. Just press down to pop it out and pop it into your new fog light the opposite way. All right, so now that we have that plastic piece in, we're gonna do a bit of wiring. So what we have to do here is determine what side is power and ground on your particular truck and wire it up to the power and ground of this light. Now on our truck, on the male connector, the power is orange and it's on the left side. So we're gonna mate that up to our connector here, to go to power on the left side, which is the black wire with the white stripe. So we're going to orient our connector to have power on this left side. To do this, we're just going to put the pins into the connector. Make sure that they're in this orientation with the lip on the inside so that they can clip in place. And we're going to press our power wire in to the left side and press our ground wire in, probably to do these simultaneously. Don't force them, they want to go the path of least resistance. Go ahead and press them into place. Should hear a click. If you can't get this by hand, you can use a tool and just gently push on the back. All right, let's get it installed. All right, so make sure you have the proper side. We have the right side, so RH will be on the back of your fog light. Slide the connector through the hole in the bumper. And this is just gonna clip in place the exact way that you unclipped the old one. So look for those retainers and clip it in place. All right, now we're gonna install the spring to hold tension on your fog light and the screw in the bottom to hold it in place. All right, so once you have your screw in place, grab a Phillips head screwdriver and tighten it down. All right, so now you can see a little bit of what I was talking about before. This orange one on our truck is power. That's gonna mate up to the wire with the white stripe, power on this side. Go ahead and plug it in. And just double check that this lights up before we keep moving. All right, with that fully installed, line up that metal bracket that we uninstalled earlier. Once all of the bolts are installed and you're sure of the adjustment on this bracket, I would go for where you had it when it came off. Looks to be right about there. Grab your 15 millimeter socket, and again, you may want a swivel for this top one. Go ahead and tighten it down. Moving on to the one underneath it, grab your 15 millimeter socket to tighten it down. Repeat that process on the other side. All right, now we can reinstall the wheel well liner. Now what you wanna do is line it up to the holes in the bracket that you just installed. We're gonna press it into place. Next up, reinstall the two bolts. Grab your 7/32 socket and tighten these down. All right, now that we have the factory fog light uninstalled from our truck, we can check it out side by side with our new fog light here. And as you can see, the most obvious difference is the black surround of our new fog light. This is gonna give your bumper a sleeker, more aftermarket look. In addition, there is a functional difference as well. This factory fog light is a reflector style, and it would come factory with just a halogen bulb. Now, this one features a projector style lens, which comes with an LED. This is going to get you a brighter and more focused beam of light with the projector style lens, where the reflector sort of spreads the light out. It is important to keep in mind with this particular truck, they have upgraded to an LED. So yours, if it is factory, will have that factory halogen bulb. So with that said, let's check out our install. All right, now we can repeat that entire process on the other side. Start by removing your pop clips to remove this wheel well liner. Next up, grab a 7/32 socket to remove the two bolts on either side. All right, next up, grab your 15mm socket to remove the two bolts on the outside of the support brace. Then once those are removed, we're going for the inside closer to the frame. Grab your 15mm socket. And you may want a swivel for this top one. And remove it. Next up, we're gonna unplug this connector. Now these colors are different, so you're gonna wanna just double check which is power and which is ground on here. And then with a Phillips head screwdriver, we're gonna loosen and remove this screw. And next up, to get the fog light itself out of the housing, what you're gonna do is grab your flathead screwdriver from before and pry away on both sides here so that it can push out the front. All right, so once you have one side released, release the other side. And you can wiggle it forward and out. All right, so what we have to do here, like the other side, is transfer over this plastic piece that holds in our screw. Transfer it to your new light and press it into place. All right, now we're gonna wire up our fog light. Now the best bet is to double check what is on your truck. Our truck has a brown wire that is the same configuration as the other side, so we're gonna be putting this power wire, black with white stripe, into the left side. It's the same process as the other connector. Line up both of your pins. Don't force them, there is a way that they wanna go through the connector. So wiggle them around until they find their path and then press them into place. Now you do wanna hear a click when they are fully seated. All right, let's get it installed. All right, now you can install the fog light, run the wiring harness through the bumper, and then you're gonna snap each of these sides in the same as your factory. All right, now you can see a little bit what I was talking about before. The brown wire is your power wire. That's gonna match up to the white and black stripe, and the connectors will go together as so. Definitely worth double checking, as your truck may be different. Go ahead and tuck your wire out of the way. Let's get this bolted up. Slide your spring back between the bracket on your light and the bracket on your housing. And thread your screw through there. Grab a Phillips head screwdriver and tighten it down. Okay, now we can reinstall the support bracket. Grab your 15 millimeter socket and tighten them down. We're gonna start with this top one. You may want a swivel for this. Now tighten the ones on the outside as well. If you don't want to push up on this, you can use a swivel for this top one too. All right, now we're gonna install the cover, starting with the pop clips. Line up the clips to the holes in that bracket that we just installed and press them into place. Next up, we're gonna install the small bolts, one on each side. Grab your 7/32 socket and tighten them down. All right, so that is gonna do it for the review and install of these fog lights. And remember, for all things Super Duty, keep it at AmericanTrucks.com.